So how far apart do we plant our fruit trees? Let's talk about that next. Everyone, this is Dwayne with Edge of Nowhere Farm, and we're coming to you here this morning, a very early morning on August 1st, 2021. We have 170 fruiting trees, vines, and shrubs here on the farm, and what we wanted to do today was talk about one of the questions we seem to get pretty often, and that's how far apart do you space your fruit trees? So let's see if we can demystify that just a little bit here today with some very specific information. So we're going to actually walk you through several different types of planting and spacing that we have here on the farm. So it'll give you an idea of kind of what our thought process is when we space out our trees, and hopefully that'll help you decide what's the perfect spacing for you as well. What we're gonna start with would be our primary orchards, and you're seeing one behind me here. So let's talk a little bit about the actual spacing we have here on our trees. What you see behind me here are two semi-dwarf peach trees. We have an eastern orchard that's set up just like this. This is our western orchard, and then also most of our citrus trees are all set up on the same spacing that you're seeing here. We have three rows of trees, and each row is offset. The spacing between each one of the trees is 16 feet, and then the spacing between the rows is about 12. Now, because the trees are offset, we still wind up with about 16 feet of spacing, and that's on the trunk between each one of these trees. Now, that spacing is very important because we want to make sure these trees can reach their full potential, especially in the width of the tree. So most of your semi-dwarf trees are going to top out at about 15 to 20 feet. Obviously, they can get taller than that naturally, and then they're going to be about 15 feet wide or so. Again, that's give or take. So our 16-foot spacing gives essentially enough space so that each one of the trees can be as wide as they should be able to get and basically just touch. So it'll be basically a solid block of trees across each one of our rows. So that's within each row, 16-foot spacing. Each row offset. So if you think about it, it's kind of a triangle. You have two trees here, and then a tree in the next row is between those two. And that, with the 12-foot spacing across, gives us, again, about 16, maybe a little more than 16 feet between each and every trunk. So no matter what, I can have a tree that is about 15 feet in diameter. Think of it, the radius being about 7 to 8 feet, and you can come either way from either tree, and again, you hit that 16-foot spacing. Hopefully that makes sense. The whole goal here is these trees we can allow to get full size, and we shouldn't have an issue with them essentially competing for space as far as how the distance between the two trees. Now, as we back away, you'll see these trees here are about a year and a half old. They're growing nice and aggressive for the most part, and you can see just how much space we still have between these young trees. But at the same time, you can see that gap is starting to close. Plenty of space on that 16-foot spacing for a semi-dwarf tree to essentially be left on its own without any heavy pruning, and it can basically grow to its natural height and width. Now for the widest spacing that we have here on the farm. What you see behind me here are several mulberry trees and a few pecan trees on the very back part of the property. Now, these trees are full-size trees, meaning they're gonna be 40, 50, or 60 feet, maybe even more than that on a pecan tree fully grown, and a good 20 to 30 feet wide plus on your mulberry trees. So the spacing we have for these is 30 feet between each trunk. Let's slide up above these so you can get a better idea what it looks like. You'll see we have multiple varieties of mulberries here. We have a couple different types of Persian mulberry and also Pakistani mulberries, all full-size trees designed to get as wide as 30 to 40 feet wide. and the pecan trees are about the same. So again, back to the spacing, that 30-foot spacing is going to allow each one of those trees to get about 30 feet wide without really pushing into the other tree. So again, 15 feet from one tree plus 15 feet from another, if you cut that diameter in half, you have enough space for those trees to essentially grow to full size and not press into each other from the sides. Full spacing here for these full-size trees that we have as a backdrop to the farm. Now what I want to do is slide up to the front of the farm. Let's talk about some smaller spacing that you can use on your trees. We're here at the front of the farm, and this is where we have some of our tropical trees. You'll see a white guava behind me, and then a pink guava heading back, a strawberry guava and a pineapple guava. All of these trees are evergreens. They're generally smaller trees, so, you know, 10 to 15 feet tall, probably about as wide at their full complete size. However, we don't plan on allowing them to get that big. And the main reason is because we have to protect these trees during the winter time, you know, when we get down into the 20s. So we are going to keep these trees smaller, more of a dwarf size. And we, because of that, because of the control we're gonna put on these trees, we can actually have them spaced much, much closer together, as you can see here. In fact, our spacing on these trees is right at about 6 feet. These are typically semi-dwarf trees that we're gonna keep pruned down to a smaller size, more of a dwarf size, which is gonna allow us to put a much tighter spacing on these trees. More work on our part, but it allows us to manage these trees. Now what I wanna do is take a look at something a little bit different when it comes to dwarf citrus trees. These are our kumquat trees. We have four varieties here on this section of the farm. And as you can see, these are much closer together. These trees are dwarf varieties, so they're not designed to get very big. They're notorious for growing slow and producing well, but we don't need to give them quite as much space. So what we have here is we have these trees all set up to split the water between two trees, and the trees themselves are only about 3 feet apart, maybe four at the most. So very, very tight spacing. The goal with this also was basically a hedge. We have the entrance to the farm back behind you, and you'll see our chicken coop and run is behind us. So we wanted to basically block that with a hedge, and these trees with this spacing are gonna allow us to do that. Now, of course, with spacing like this, even though they're dwarf trees, they still can get about 6 to 8 feet wide, which means they'll definitely push into each other. But again, that's kind of by design. We want that to happen. So a little more work on our part once these get a little bit bigger, but you can see this tighter spacing actually works really good with these dwarf varieties. What you see behind me here would be Illinois ever-bearing mulberries. These are set up as a hedge with our chicken coop and run in the backdrop. These trees are designed to shade our chickens in the afternoon, this being the western part of the sky here. So these trees are designed to grow together. It's all the same variety. The spacing that we have between these is right at 10 feet. These trees are semi-dwarf trees, so they're gonna push 15 to 20 feet tall at their max and about the same width, which is gonna allow them to grow into each other from either side and make that nice hedge that we're looking for. What you see behind me here would be our Flame grapevines this way and our Thompson grapevines this way. Both of these are table grapes, but grapes in general can be set up on this type of system. These particular varieties are gonna be designed for production, so keep that in mind as we're talking about our spacing. We have these set up on a traditional vineyard spacing and system. So we have a 6 foot section essentially designated for all of the growth and production for each one of the vines. So every single trunk is about 6 feet apart. That allows for plenty of production for each one of the vines. Now with grapevines, you can adjust that slightly. So you can go wider for sure. So an 8 foot spacing, even 10 foot spacing is fine. You could also pare it back if you needed to. But if you're gonna be going for production, they really tend to do best with about 6 to 8 feet of distance between each one of the vines. Now, one of the things with grapevines is they need to be pruned heavily in order for you to get good, solid, regular production. In fact, typically we prune about 90 to 95% of the new growth off of the vines, and then the new production from the following year comes back off of what you leave. If you're using a trellis design, spacing is really not so important. The key, of course, is gonna be that heavy pruning that you're gonna need to do if you're looking for production. This is one of our Primark blackberries, and you can see that we have it in a bed, and that's because we really prefer to have a heavy, heavy mulch system, and we want to make sure that these vines have space to spread out. Your blackberry vines generally will send runners out underneath the ground, and they will get pups that'll pop up all over the place in here. And essentially, you have berry bushes as each one of those comes up. We want to allow these to have plenty of space to do just that, but at the same time, controlling the area that they're in. So we find that a raised bed with about a 10-foot by 6-foot size. Now, you don't have to use this spacing. You don't even have to put them in beds. Just realize that those pups are gonna come up wherever you have them, and you'll need to deal with the pups. So now, if you wanted to make this a hedge, you could definitely put them much closer together and make a beautiful blackberry hedge. A lot of folks will do that. So as far as spacing, I would say you'd probably wanna give yourself about 4 to 6 feet, maybe 8 if you can, between each vine to allow them plenty of space to develop. Now, we also realize that this is not typical. Most of you out there are not gonna have this much space. Hopefully we've given you some options as far as how we have this set up and some different things you can do. Now, one of the things that we have tested on the old farm, we had double plantings, and those were trees that cross-pollinated each other. Those were set at about a 2-foot spacing. And the only issue we found is that one tree always dominated another. Another thing, I think we made an error in how we planted them. We had them planted east and west, so one was east of the other and west and vice versa. So we had them planted that way. I think you need to switch that and have them planted north and south, because you want to make sure that both trees get both morning sun and afternoon sun. This way you don't have shading on one or the other, and of course those trees need that full sun. As far as spacing by tree, you have your dwarf varieties, which are your smallest. They're gonna naturally be, you know, 6 to 8 feet tall, maybe 10 feet tall at the most, and about as wide. So those you can plant much closer together, like you saw here. The roots are not as aggressive, so they're not gonna out-compete each other that way. You might wanna keep into consideration that north-south planting, which I think would be ideal. And if you give yourself about 4 to 5 feet, I think that's plenty of space with very little additional work for you if you can give them that. Your semi-dwarf trees that are gonna be anywhere from 15 to 20, 25 feet tall and about as wide. For us, we use that 16-foot spacing, which I think is the most you need to go. So if you cut that in half, I think about the only thing that you're gonna face there is just the need to prune much more heavily in order to make sure you're not gonna have any issues with shading on your trees and, of course, access. Your full-size trees that are gonna be 30, 40 feet plus, both in height and width, we use a 30-foot spacing because it's gonna give them enough distance between so that they're not gonna press up against each other and compete for light, etc. However, again, same thing. If you use a smaller spacing, it's gonna be a matter of pruning. And that, I think, is the biggest issue when it comes to your fruit tree spacing. How much time you're willing to give to the tree and caring for the tree. If you give them ideal spacing, so a larger amount of space, you're just gonna have less work that you're gonna need to do as far as pruning and maintenance. They're gonna have plenty of space on their own, and you don't need to give them the space. The closer together your trees are, the more time you're gonna have to give. In particular, you're gonna have to keep an eye on pruning and manage their size much more aggressively than if you had more space. Also keep in mind, as you get closer together, you are gonna have trees start to compete. They're gonna compete for water, they're going to compete for nutrition, and of course, depending on how they're placed, as far as sun is concerned, they may start competing for sunlight. Fruit trees need full sun. Even here in Arizona, we've shown you that. So anytime you have shading, you're gonna have some issue with overall growth and production from that tree. So hopefully today's video kind of demystified the whole idea of ideal spacing for a fruit tree. As you can see, there are lots of different options, and really depends on how much time you're willing to give the tree so you get the most out of what you want. Be that production or beauty, it's really up to you. So just wanna thank you for joining us today. If you haven't done so already, subscribe to the channel. This is one of the things we do the most, it seems, which is fruit trees. We have a lot of experience with it and enjoy sharing that, but would love to see you as a subscriber and share the content. If you know anybody that would be interested in something like this, it really helps us out here if you would share it. And our Amazon shop, that is another free, painless way to help support the channel. If you start with a link down below, it doesn't matter what you buy, you help to support us here. So just wanna thank you for joining us today and remind you, if we can farm on the edge of nowhere, so can you. It's about 60, am I doing that right? 10 by 6, 60 square feet? Math, first thing in the morning. Can be a challenge. Pretty sure it's 60 square feet.